Hey yo, what is going on, guys? I'm your host, Josh Costanza. I have the Arturo Fuente chat till Maduro, and you're watching Viper Smokes. Getting into the information about this beautifully well-constructed cigar is the binder and filler is a Dominican Republic. Binder and filler comes from the Dominican Republic. The wrapper is a U.S. Connecticut broadleaf. Take it for what you will. Now that the awkward pause is over, let's get into the cut and light. Welcome to the first thirds. Had a brain fart. Welcome to the first thirds, guys, of the Arturo Fuente Chateau Maduro. The flavor profile on the inhale is a combination of two things. It's a combination of black coffee, and the lingering aftertaste is a somewhat of a licorice. I don't know if it's just because it is the Maduro wrapper on it, but this thing is just full of deliciousness. Retrohale always burns the eyes a little bit. Is something dark, like a dark chocolate. Spice, maybe black pepper, but overall, it's a really great cigar. Let's hop into the second third, see what the second thirds has to offer. See you guys there. Hey, what is going on, guys? Welcome back to Viper Smokes. We're getting into the second thirds. Let's not bullshit around. Let's hop straight in to the flavor profile. On the regular exhale, it's still got all the flavor notes that I've been talking about. It's got the black coffee flavor notes. It's got either a licorice or toffee note that I can't dictate whether it's the one or the other. And, you know, it's got a little bit, just a tad bit of dark chocolate taste. Let's get into the retrohale, and I know this is going to burn the crap out my nose, so let's just go ahead and get it done. On the retrohale, it's got a lot of spices. I don't get any of the other flavor notes besides coffee on the retrohale, and it has a lingering aftertaste as well that isn't quite bad. I actually enjoy the aftertaste of this cigar, but I will say this, drinking pure black tea or a black coffee will get rid of that aftertaste of the cigar. I know that personally because, like I previously said, this is my everyday go-to. which could be either a good thing if you want a lingering aftertaste, or if you just want something that is a great cigar but you don't want an aftertaste. It's good either way. Let's hop into the final thirds and see what the final thirds has to offer for this cigar. Hey yo, what is going on, guys? Welcome back to Viper Smokes. We're in the final thirds of this cigar review. Okay, let's hop in straight into it. Okay, it is storming outside, so if you guys can hear that, I apologize. It's the same. It's literally the same. It's got that dark chocolate. It's got the coffee. It's got the either licorice or, you know, toffee notes. But either way, no matter when or what you pick up, I do recommend this. I would recommend this to the very first cigar smoker who is, you know, hasn't smoked a single cigar in their life and they're wanting to get into it, or the everyday cigar enthusiast who just loves, breathes, eats, sleeps cigars. I would recommend this to them if they haven't had it yet. It's an overall well-balanced smoke, which is, again, I reiterate why I put this at my everyday cigar when I want something consistent and I want something tasty and delicious. I will go to this when I don't want to try anything else in this shop. I go to this because it is just that perfect. If I was the part of the Fuente family and I was there when they were thinking of another cigar and they were thinking of this one, I would have recommended them putting a name either in Latin or some other language that has the word perfect. Because that's what this cigar is. It's perfect. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm your host, Josh Costanza, and you're watching Viper Smokes. Tell me pretty lies, look me in the face.